Happy 4th of July, week past Happy 4th of July.
What?
Yeah? You're waking up now. Amen. Good morning. We welcome you to our service. Do we have any first-time attenders? I don't recognize anybody as first-time. I see some folks that haven't been here in a while, and we're so glad you're back. And if I try to mention one, I'll miss out on somebody. So I don't want to start that, but so we welcome you. You know who you are, and if it's been a while since you've been here, we are so pleased that you're here this morning. Hey, we have a visitor with us, but we actually have two visitors with us, but they're two will be one. They're so much one. It's just remarkable. So brother and sister Riffitt, they're with us this morning. Welcome them. So I'll tell you a good story right now. I was invited, my wife and I, Amber, to go to a baseball game Friday night at Bluefield. So we decided to go, and then during the week, I asked Brother Riffitt if they would like to go. So he, yeah. I thought, old fuddy-duddies, they ain't gonna go. So that's supposed to be funny. I didn't mean anything by it. Okay, thank you. So then I asked them again on Friday. I said, are you going to go to the baseball? Let me ask Loretta. And I heard him hollering at her. She said, yeah, we're going. So we went. Oh, my goodness. You shouldn't take old people to baseball games. Do what? We did have a blast. We cut up and carried on and laughed. And we had three sticks in the mud sitting down right in front of us. Stick one, stick two, and stick three. And you could tell they did not enjoy the baseball game near as much as we did. So I think it was after the seventh inning, they got up and they moved over here. I thought, well, that's fine. And y'all was bothering me anyway. Y'all was in my space. So we was up there trying to help the umpire out. And do y'all know umpires can't see? Oh my goodness. And they can't, they don't do it like they used to. You know, used to, they go, strike, whoa! And now they go. So I thought, I'd help him out a little bit. So he went, and I go, strike, whoa! So we had a good time, and I heard him tell his wife after what a good time he had. So even though it was late getting him back to their home there, we still had a good time. And being out with people, you find out a whole lot about them. No, this is good. This is all right. We go to Wendy's, and he wants to order a double. I thought, Brother Riffitt, you don't want to order a double. I can't eat a double. And I thought, you don't want to eat a double. Guess what? He did. He wanted it and he ate it. So he just amazed me the other night. Oh, come on in. Walk over in front of the camera if you want. Panama Bob's here, so. You do look good in white. Yeah. So, God bless you. Amen. We had a good time. Wow! We welcome everybody viewing by live stream this morning. But live stream is not live stream because the internet's down here for some reason at the church. So it will be uploaded after a while. Sorry, you folks. You'll get it a little bit late. Youth meeting tonight at 5:30. Oh, Hannah, come on. And right now's a good time for you to talk. You may have to turn it up.
Can you hear me? Yep. Okay, so we are getting ready for camp, which is not this coming week, but the next week. We're going to leave from church on Sunday about 1 o'clock probably, because we're going to eat lunch here, feed the kids, and then head to Blacksburg. There is still time for your children to sign up. They just have to let us know by today. The 7th through 12th graders will be going all week, so they're going to be Sunday to Saturday morning. 3rd through 6th graders are also all week. The little guys are going to come Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. And then if some of them just want to come for the day, they can come on Friday. We need men to come and help. Please. Like, if you're feeling the Lord convicting you right now, maybe. But we really need some guys to come help us. Help Leroy. So if Leroy seem looking sad, pity him a little bit, maybe. I don't know. But yeah, if any of you guys, we would really love, even if you could come down for the day or something, even if you want to spend the night, that'd be even better. But yes, we could really use some guys to come help us at camp to make it more enjoyable for the young men, because they don't want to be stuck with us women all the time. But we have a meeting after church today, immediately following service, no more than like 15 minutes, just for the leaders that are going to come help. We just want to give you a rundown of what's going, go over the schedule, that sort of thing. But again, kids still have time to sign up. If they have not signed up, just let us know today. Today is the cutoff. But we would love to have you guys. Camp is a blessing, and you will leave blessed. You'll leave really, really tired, but really, really blessed, I promise.
Yes.
So, yeah, we'd love to have you guys if you want to come help us out. But yeah.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. Hannah and Amber and others that work with the children, thank you. Wow. If we didn't have our youth workers, we'd be in a mingle, wouldn't we?
Amen.
Yeah, because you'd have to be doing it. More of it. So, yeah, if you're able to go help, please come to the meeting today. Evening service tonight at 6 o'clock. Brother Riffitt will be our guest speaker. Sister Riffitt will be our guest singer again this evening. So please come out. We are needing to purchase hymnals for the overflow and balcony. We've talked about that several times. Men's prayer breakfast is coming Saturday at 8:30 a.m. Oh, no, no, no. 8 a.m. I don't know why I put 8:30. I think that says 8:32 maybe. I don't know. So it's 8 o'clock. Sorry. Blood drive here on July the 22nd. If you'd like to come and give blood, please call the church office to make an appointment. You can also do it online. There's several different ways, so whichever way is more convenient for you. Any other announcements this morning?
4-H awards.
4-H awards, yes, ma'am. You have to tell me. I can't remember.
I'm just proud that we have two.
And Lindsay. Oh yeah, yeah.
Presley. She got Camper of the Week.
Presley, stand up. That's pretty awesome, you know.
That's awesome.
Back up. So everybody couldn't hear Angie. Presley and our group of Bland County campers went this week. So she was the camper of the week. So that's a big deal. And we are so proud of her. And to go and to still have 4-H camp and do all the good things that 4-H does, we're just grateful and thankful for that group. And thank you, Presley. Let's give her another hand. AJ, where are you at, AJ? Come down here to the front of the balcony. We'll get a better shot at you that way. No, I'm kidding. Hurry up. Come on now. I was just kidding about shooting you. I want you to come down here. So don't hang over too far. So AJ also was at camp. And what did AJ win? He was...
Respect pillar.
Uh-huh.
Respect
uh-huh.
is awesome.
That is awesome. Amen.
And a friendship stick.
Do what?
And a friendship stick.
Oh, wait a minute. Hey, whoa. Hey, come back down here. AJ. You said what now?
A friendship stick.
And a friendship stick.
Amen.
A good friend. Amen.
That's awesome.
Wait. I'm kidding. I'm really kidding. This time. Those are some good boys. Amen. Any other awards given out? Anybody knows that at 4-H camp? Awesome. Thank you. Thank you for letting your kids go to 4-H camp. Thank you for allowing your children to go to church camp. Hannah said, a lot of folks will be really, really tired, but they'll also be really, really blessed. So look forward to those days that the children and the youth have with them. Any other announcements this morning? Thank you for your building fund giving. June total, $10,027. July month of date, $2,696. Amen. Happy birthday today, no tomorrow, to Donald Music. Happy birthday tomorrow, Donald. You're going to be... I ain't going to do that. He's going to be 60, I think, right? 60? You going to be 60? I can't believe it. Yes, I can. Donald and my brother graduated together. Steve turned 60, so it's Donald's turn. Happy birthday. Lexi Emerson, Tanya Emerson on Tuesday. Jim Starks, not Jim's here, on the 15th. Happy birthday, Jim. Audrey Crisp on the 17th of July. Any other birthdays this week? Last week, we did not sing happy birthday to Krista Jones and Kathy Wellman as we should have. So we'll combine them all together this morning as we sing. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Chi-Chi's not here, so what's up? So we'll find out what's up. Amen. Please stand as we go to the Lord in prayer. Father, it is good to be in your house this morning. Lord, I've been anticipating again this week. Lord, we should anticipate every week, Lord, but just to have brother and sister Riffitt with us. Lord, thank you. Been around them long enough, Lord, to know that they are the real deal. They're not in this for fame and fortune. Lord, they're in this because they have a great love for you and they desire to see people come to know Jesus as their Savior and Christians to walk a closer walk with you. And I thank you. Thank you for them. Thank you for their ministry. Lord, although it'll just be two services this time, Lord, there'll be another day and we'll be able to share more time with them. So, Father, we thank you. We pray a blessing upon them, upon what you've given him to speak, Sister Lorette to sing to us today. Lord, we just thank you for all of your blessings. Lord, for this time that we have together to worship you. Lord, even though she'll be singing, Lord, she's singing to you and just allowing us to listen in. So, thank you. Thank you for the songs that have been picked out for us to sing today. Lord, that we may praise you and thank you for your many blessings. We give you honor and glory in your house because you are so good. Father, we thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. God is so good. God is so good. Thank you for this time to worship you and to give you praise. It's in Jesus' name we pray. All of God's people said,
Amen.
Amen. And Brother Charlie's come to lead us in a couple of songs this morning.
This is one of my favorite writers. One of my favorite writers is Fanny Crosby. I said that she wrote maybe over 8,000 songs. Somebody put the music to all her words, and they're beautiful. First, we're going to sing, "To God Be the Glory."
To God be the glory, great things he hath done.
Still take the bread, and we can still take the cup, and we understand what it means. Well, your word tells us if we don't understand what it means, then we shouldn't take it. If we're not a Christian, we shouldn't take it. And it's more than understanding. We got to know. We got to be a believer before communion, before we take communion. That's according to your word. So, Father, this morning, help us all to take it. And then the Bible talks about it being in a worthy fashion. That's the worthy fashion. Lord, I said some things years ago that maybe not been quite as right. But, Lord, that's right. Lord, the requirement to taking communion is that we have a relationship with Jesus Christ. Because what can we remember if there's not been an event in our life that we are remembering? So what we are remembering is that Jesus gave his body for us. By his stripes, we are healed, not were, but are healed. Whew. That means a little bit more than it used to.
Yes.
Mm.
Thank you, Lord.
By his stripes, we are healed. Sins are covered in the blood. We know that. We thank you. And we confess our sins. You are faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness and cover our sins in your blood. And the Lord speaks that he can't see through your blood. Throws the sins that we've committed as far as the east is from the west. We thank you. We thank you for that this morning. We remember and we worship. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Everyone say it. Amen. Father, thank you for this ordinance of the church. Lord, our church continues. Lord, I was going to say tradition. I don't want it to be a tradition. I want it to be something that we do because we want to. We want to remember. We want to praise. We want to honor you and thank you for what you've done. So, Father, this morning, as we worship, as we continue to worship, Lord, may we honor you with our voice, with our very being. We praise you. All God's people said, amen, amen. Please stand. Brother Scott's coming to lead you in a couple of songs.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Let all the earth rejoice.
Did y'all hear them little fellers up here singing? I saw a lot of you looking back that way and grinning, and you know, isn't that something? What's that tell you? If we like it, God loves it. And if we got three or four little dudes that can belt it out like that, what's wrong with the rest of us? Amen? We're old, but we can do better than what we do. I'm not bashing nobody, but that's awesome. I looked at Brother Charlie, and he's just grinning like a possum. And I know, and then I saw Carol, and she was looking back that way, and it was awesome to hear, and their voices just carried up right through here. So praise the Lord. That's awesome. So we are so blessed to have young folks in our church. We are blessed to have Brother and Sister Riffitt this morning, and I believe she is going to come and sing to us first. Amen? So welcome Sister Loretta as she comes.
Different. Something had happened. one of you to pray for us. Continue to pray. I need your prayer. Thank you very much. God bless you. I love you.
Amen.
His unchanging hand.
Whatever the problem, he'll bring me out. Woo. I've had the sadness of losing a friend.
Glorifying till his return, I'll stand firm rooted. living God's word. I'm yielding to deception, determined to go on. Though threatened by principalities, I'm not ever left alone. For up on this rock I'll take my stand. I'll have no part in shifting sands. And when I face the powers of hell, by God's grace I shall prevail. I'm not compromising. I'm not jeopardizing. Why? To change some things, we must ask ourselves, if this day was your last, would it change some things? No one knows how many days they've been given. Just suppose this was the last one you'd be living. Would you want to watch the sunset or sit and watch TV? Would you waste a single word you'd say or choose it carefully? If this day was your last, what would you be doing? All the precious moments pass. Would your life change or stay the same in the little time you had? What would you do different if this day was your last? Think about all the daily things you deal with. Cars, cows, and phones, bills, and business. With every moment fleeting, would they mean near as much? Bet you'd trade all you own for love. If this day was your last, what would you be doing while the precious moments your life change will stay the same in the little time you have? What would you do different if this day was your last? Well, if you waste your time, think you waste your life, and since we can't go back, sometimes you need to ask. If your life change will stay the same in the little time you have. What would you be doing if this day was your last?
Darkness,